Greetings and welcome to the broadcast. I'm your host. This is part two. We're in an underground vault looking at some very rare books, basically looking at these woodcuts, fantastic woodcuts, getting a message off of them, any kind of rare maps we might find, and that's about it. Now here's some guys holding baseball bats and holding a crown. I wonder how many fingers they've got. I just want to sensitize you to that. All right, they've got some kind of a logo in the center here. And I don't recall seeing this logo before. Now, we've seen this before. We're starting to get some repetition here of the globe. Now, here's a pretty clean-looking icon. Nothing really bad here. Oh, here's an older book. Whenever I tap it, that means I think I've seen something. Now, look at this map. See the meridian lines on top up there, how they're really arced in? They didn't really depict their thoughts on a globe transition back then very well, but they were trying, and this map shows the transition period, the kind of a work of infancy back then in those maps. When I look to the bottom, look where Antarctica may or may not be, maybe not on this map. Okay. Now I'm going to show, look at the, okay, I thought we had some meridian lines, we don't. I'm going to show you why it's important to, now see, up there it's 40, 60, 80 increments up there, that's important. Now, here's India. It's important to have your Bible software with you. What do you think about India? It's mentioned in the old King James Version, isn't it? It's mentioned twice. Here it talks about India and Ethiopia. However, when we decipher these maps and do a deep forensic, look here, 120-some provinces. So we want to try to reconcile those provinces with old, rare maps. So there's something you always want to file this away mentally when you do a forensic for somebody. They ask you to look at a book. If you want me to look at a book, it's $500 a pop or something like this and give an interpretation, or we'll do it for free here on YouTube. You can easily train yourself to do it. I'll give it to you for free. The software is free. Oh, there's Africa. Here, one more Bible lesson. The nation of Put, sometimes spelled P-U-T or P-H-U-T, is a wonderful history. It's all over the place. People can't find it on Africa. It moves around on the old maps. It's in the Bible for a reason. Why, I don't know. Let's take a look here, see if we can find it. I've found it a few times in the upper right part. Oh, look, there's no Antarctica down there. No land bridge on this map. Upper right part, the nation of Put. Now, look up upper right. You might just see part of it. Let's grab the Bible real quick here. Here's what they're talking about. The book of Ezekiel. This is important. P-H-U-T is spelled here. It's a nation. It's disputed. It did exist. And if you find it on a map, you can weave this thing in with a clever interpretation of Scripture and really discover some things and make sense of things. Now, here's some different notations down here, Ethiopian stuff. You want to always note this thing mentally when you look at maps and try to weave in Scripture. And it's like a puzzle. All you're doing is solving a puzzle. You're not adding. Now, I'm having to hold my fingers like this for a reason, and you will too. The worms of bookworms have eaten out the bottom of this paper so bad that it wants to come up. I'll show you here in a minute. Look to the bottom here. See what they've done? There's no, they just can't control the paper there. I didn't want to have it that way. Now, folks, excuse me. This paper contains a lot of spring. See the meridian lines? How they're more and more blended like a globe? This paper, when it's almost 400 years old, it's unbelievable. It can be folded for 200 years and has the spring in it, almost like new paper. I'm going to give a demonstration a little bit later of how it holds the spring. And again, this ink, 300 years old, it doesn't bleed, it doesn't wash out, it doesn't go through from one side of the paper to the other. This is a real, Carthage, I think we saw there, a real good example of woodcuts. Okay, Greece, we've seen that. Let's grab some more books here. Time's running out. Oh, anytime you see Stadia, of course, you're about 1720, 1730 in these kinds of books. All right, see our little legend up there? Now you're looking at maps with a new eye. Hey, this wait a minute. This is almost a flat earth, isn't it? Those lines, those meridian lines running down don't show any bend to the earth at all. They're kind of square. Now, of course, it's a smaller dimension of earth. But just file this away. They're always trying to get their story straight. All right, island of Crete. We've all seen that before. And this one I don't recognize. We're getting into some retreat of maps here. This is great. I'm going to go ahead and show some maps here for the people that like it, and then I'll come back in just a bit. I'll just let it run. Boy, you can't but be happy you've seen old treasures like this with the dates on it. Here we've seen this over and over again. Now, there's no depiction of the moon on this one that I see. It's a little bit different. Again, that's geocentric in there. That's the Earth portrayed in there. Oh, folks, look at here. Time's running out, but we've got some more books down here we want to look at. Indeed, we do. Let's grab some of these things and get busy here before we end up running out of time. All right, what do we see here? Okay. Oh, how many fingers are on that? There's only has three or four fingers on that angelic being. Three or four fingers here. They're telling us something with these woodcuts. I wonder what that could be. All right, we've seen this quite a few times before. I don't know why it's coming up, but it's and the old phoenix bird getting ready to take a nip off this thing here. Oh, 1688. Okay, that was worth the ride. Now we've got some old books that are very dry paper. You just feel the dryness in there. Yeah, very good. I'm having trouble with the focus. I'm down here in an archive vault, and the light's funny. I'll get it sharpened up in the focus here, but these are difficult photography sessions. Now we're looking at something more regimented. This is a very special book here. This is out of Scotland. The artwork's going to change. You can see there's going to be a little bit more detail, a different technique in here. I'm going to blow one of these up real big. Now here's... they sometimes say black people. They call them different things back in the days back here. There's black people hidden in these things. Now, here's an obelisk right out of the Masonic Lodge, Freemason, a little bit of a cult. And that's what you're going to get in these places. Lines were kind of blurred back then. Anyway, if there are black people in here, fine. It was just something that was a different time back then. If we see some, we'll mention it. Now, this map, look at this paper, folded for a couple hundred years, and just that easy, it holds the snap. That's a hand-colored map, possibly where rituals took place with the Masonic Lodge, or just a tourist map. Who knows what that thing is? If we had a lot of time, we could really build a case here, and that takes a lot of time. But when I release this paper, you would think, how could it stay folded like that? And it just does a real good job of going back home like it's supposed to, and holding the color all those many, many years without blurring. So now look at this thing here, about the size of, a business card. Now let's blow that. There are some black people. Those are said to be black people, at least one down there. I don't know which one it is. And then we're going to go up here, and I'm going to blow it up and show you again, this is woodcut. This is the size of a business card. Let me get the photo. I'll just put my thumb in here just for size reference. I'm going to blow those buildings up in the back. This was done with a piece of wood and a knife. If you look at this thing, almost a 3D dimension. You can almost see people back in there. It takes a microscope to appreciate these woodcuts. All kinds of codes back. Now, here's a thing, a possible apocalyptic scenario, a couple, husband, wife, team on the bottom. Above is either apocalypse or some kind of event taking place. Now, here we've got some horizontal stuff. The pictures were a little bit different back then, like the way they laid them in. A little bit of an arc down there on the bottom we could look at. Now, the black people are supposed to be hiding lower right. Do you see them? Okay, let's go on down and take a look. Apparently, there's either one black person either walking on a road or living in a tent down in here. We'll go down a little bit. We'll have to keep going down there until you see it. Okay. And this will be the last time we're going to look for it down there. See if there's some people hidden, living in a tent, and one of them is walking on a road. I think on the lower right, there is a tent down there, some people living, and there's somebody walking on a road. Now, look at this paper experiment. Somebody tore this book up. We did not do this, but I'm going to put it back together for him. When I release this paper, it will almost jump out of my hand after a couple hundred years. Fantastic stuff, and fold it right back up. Let's go ahead. Let's figure out why people leave these things torn up, I don't know. It's easy to put these books back. Watch it go. Let it go. Pop. There. Isn't that amazing paper to do that? That's something. Now we can put it back together a little bit and leave it better like it's supposed to be left for the next person. Some people just tear these apart and leave them. I don't understand it. Anyway, we'll be back in just a bit to look at the cover. Okay, we're getting a chance to wrap this one up here in the lower left of that circle logo. We can see a harp. Now, it's not a 10-string harp, but you'll see a harp there. I'm going to get some real thick books here coming up to show you how much we have to go through just to get one woodcut. Not complaining now, but there's a lot of work involved. Look at the thickness of this thing. Sometimes only one woodcut in this. Some of these things were marked in libraries 100 years ago for to be disposed of. They wanted to get rid of them. Well, I'm glad they didn't do it. Look how thick that dude is. All right, what do we got here? Five fingers, five toes, a little depiction of some kind of a thing going on. Some kind of a testament here. All right, now this is worth the whole price of the book. I want you to see this. This is going to come up again. I've mentioned this. See that lightning bolts are sending the sun down in a saucer shape. On the left, there's a church. On the right, there's a phoenix bird on top of a kind of an island. And look, there's some hidden numbers up there. You see those numbers? Let's grab the Bible real quick and look into it. Excuse me. It's not really a verse up there. When we punch in the Bible about the sun burning things up or things burning up, we come over here to 2 Peter. Talks about our fervent heat. This is an end-time apocalyptic scenario. Maybe they were trying to depict that with that thing we saw. Now, look in the left. I'm going to just photograph those six different things on the left. This is kind of like a skull and bones deal here. Nothing really new under the sun. Take a look at this here at first blush. It's like, yeah, there's things going on here. And then on the bottom, how many fingers and how many toes are down there on that bottom? Did you catch that? They almost tried to make it look almost like six. Now, here's the occult ritual right here. You got a witch. She's got the witching hour at 12:30. She's holding the skull up, just like Geronimo's skull is held up by John Kerry and George Bush Jr. at their skull and bones at their fraternity. Here's a guy laying down in a stupor, seeing a type of a chemtrail, an unnatural cloud he's looking at. What else is next? Okay, here's a woman having to lay down skull and bone style with her left hand on her top of her pelvis, her right hand under her buttocks, doing a ritual. All skull and bones laying under the deal here. And where are we going with this? Okay, look at Jesus Christ. His left hand is up by a pyramid with three all-seeing eyes inside of it. Let's grab our Bible. When Jesus Christ was crucified, first it says this is Jesus, the King of the Jews, but there were two thieves on each side of his hands. But his right hand had the good thief, his left hand had the bad thief. So that's an inaccurate depiction, possibly by design. Now, here we got, just, you know, they're making pretend like they have a little library in here. And here's a new initiate, wants to come into Skull and Bones. Hey, if you've got the money and the time, they might just let you in. Well, anyway, you can have your own interpretation, but as years go by, you'll find out that things are not new under the sun. A lot of this old stuff has been going on. Oh, there's an old one here for us, early 1700s. A lot of this stuff has been going on that you read about in the... And there is a sanitization of these old books. Some of the stuff they don't really want out if you work with this so-called bloodlines of certain people. And I don't want to really get into that right now. It could hurt somebody's feelings. Anyway, I'm going to take my fist, just tap it. Just let me hear. These are real heavy books. Time is really short. We're going to have to hurry up. And this could be a real treat in here for us. Folks, unfortunately, our time is running short. We'll just drink in some of the... Look at thousands and thousands of dollars worth of books here. We never know what we're going to see. Let's get ready just to open a few of these up and get down to business here. Sure, there's a lot of Jesuit, a lot of Catholic influence in these stacks here. But again, we don't know. It could be a Protestant one or it could be anything. Let's get going. All right, this is pretty much garden variety, plain Jane vanilla. I'm not going to spend too much time on this one. No, I don't feel there's anything here. Ooh, that's the papers. This thing was improperly maintained. Boy, it's let the light go right through. It's so thin. Whoa, wait a minute. Do you see what I see? Look at that. A guy's got a dead fish. We're going to come back to that in a minute. I think he's against the Pope. The guy's got a dead fish suspended from something and a flute he's piping. You know, the Bible talks about the flutes. And I'm going to come back to that. I want the telephoto lens out here. He's playing a tune. See the man? He's playing a tune. To the right's a dead fish. And the end of that fish's head looks like what? It looks like the Pope's hat, doesn't it? With a little mitre to Dagon, the fish god. And the guy's got wings in his back. A lot of heavy symbolic imagery here, man. We could go on for a long time if we had... Uh-oh. What's going on with this one? Just tapping my fingers, signifying there's something in there. I don't see. Huh. All right. It's old. I thought there was something in here. You know, you can train your fingers just like a blackjack dealer to discover, I can, right there, there's a map hidden in there. A lot of people say you can't do that. You really can. Look, there's a map hidden. I found these a lot. The manufacturer put this in because in the old days you could be accused of sedition, man, taking a map from one country to another. It's hidden in there. You just ease it out real, real easy. And this paper has so much life in it after 350 years. It just, look at the life, like a spring almost. Wow. Most places would never let you do this, but we're being treated very kindly here. Just take a quick, you know, if you had this map, excuse me, blown up, a copy, and put on your wall, it'd be a fantastic piece of artwork. Africa. What are we looking for? Put, right? Sometimes spelled P-U-T. If you see it on here, I'll give you a kudos. Tell me where you see it at. Again, it moves around all the time on old maps. Anything sometimes to cloud certain biblical principles. Now, I don't pretend to know the biblical principles behind put, but there's a lot of argument, and there's actually wars fought Africa. Lives are lost about where the boundary of that nation is. And these old maps are just a window into the history. All right, we've got some pretty good cartography here. Let you just take a little look at the numbers. Not very clear, but this is certainly not the best example, but it's a fairly rare one. I haven't seen this exact one before. Excuse me. Yes, stadia. All right, as we go on, the maps will start depicting a little bit of their rivers going inland. I have to do these maps for the people that tune in. I'm into the maps a little bit, but not heavy. Let me just run some through here so everybody can get a sense, kind of like you were looking over my shoulder, and see what's going on. Oh, Hercules. You know, if Hercules has his name on a map, you know it's an old one. Oh, boy. Pretty good work. You know, if you were on a ship, it'd be very easy to run aground, have an accident. With these kind of maps, they didn't show everything. They weren't to real good scale. Okay, what do we got here? Okay, now, if you ever see something like this, like on the left, you don't ever look in there. If you're trying to find something, you just leave it alone. People hide stuff. Look, there's a Jesuit, a possible Freemason. Got a Freemason sign going. Let's get this little piece of thin paper off the top, which thin, and get what's under here. Okay, more room. Okay, here's a little ship. Well, there's a nice little ship. Folks, it's my sad duty to tell you we're running out of 1600s and early 1700s stuff. Basically, you just lose the energy right out of the presentation. We're going to start getting some of the newer. This ship is nice. The newer stuff, it'll be more of a less woodcut. You get to the late 1700s, early 1800s, the Pope got more and more control over creative content. You ever see something like this? That means there were a lot of people going in there. Probably an old library 150 years ago. But and then all of a sudden it becomes more and more sanitized. And that's where we're going right now. I'll go ahead. We'll finish our journey out. Let's see what's in this one. All right. Boy, they're getting a lot better with the faces and blending the woodcuts. Guys had to apprentice for decades sometimes to do these things. Now we go. See the look? Now we're in the late 1700s, early 1800s. Yeah, the quality's gone. It's sad. Well, anyway, let's go ahead. Some of these coins are after the time of Christ. When you see somebody holding a spear with these things, or a standard, has a lot to do with tin or Britannia or Britain and the things they talked about. Tin, by the way, in the Bible is mentioned as one of the metals the Lord uses to punish a nation with. That'll be a little test for you to look up. Just type in tin and see how the Lord uses that metal to discipline a nation. It's very interesting. This one here is a very famous one. That's called a standard. That's a female in her right hand. Yeah, five fingers, five toes. Thank you. And a shorter spear. This guy doesn't have much of a standard, not much of a spear. But I'll give you kind of an idea. So time is running out. Hey, thanks for stopping by here. Let me let you read this a little bit. Some people may never have a chance to ever see a book like this again. You can just speed read and pick out a few of the words and kind of string them together here. I'll just drop down slowly. The light's not that good. See how the ink is worn out? And this, they just, their heart wasn't in it. Once you get into the 1800s, it's just not there. I mean, they're good books, and I wouldn't mind having some, but what you saw earlier was the true Renaissance, the true Cadillac, the heyday of first-class woodcuts. And here you can see, getting one step away from Mary worship on the coin. Just let you drink these in a little bit. here it talks about Newcastle and sometimes Liverpool use this kind of a shape to build things. And this is interesting. He used different sized cattle to give a depth of perspective looking down there to trick your eye. We wouldn't do this in normal artwork, but they did different things back then. Nothing wrong with it. Now, it's time for a phoenix bird. It always is. You see the phoenix bird? Yep, there's his head left and right. It's a reoccurring theme in Freemasons, occult, and Illuminati bloodline stuff, or even politics now. See, who wants to see something like this after you've just seen real woodcuts? It's pretty tough to get much out of it. Hey, we're going to end up with shoes. I'm going to show you some of the oldest shoes I've ever seen, and we're going to go ahead and call it quits and get out of here and make sure everything's just the way we left it. Here's a little ghost with a thing coming, little beady eyes looking at you. You see some of that stuff. Anyway, these old shoes, they're not Nikes, but it'll be good to see those portrayed. And then after that, we'll close. Okay, again, McIsencraft, you just look at these things. That looks more like a rooster than a phoenix bird to me. There's Dagon, the fish god type of thing here. She's got a little eye there. They're always up to something. And here's just some regular star, so-called household gods. Sometimes they would have this. Now, some of this, in the time of England, there was rumored to be giants over there. Several things. Now, look here. The guy on the left almost looks inhuman or else not feeling so good. 1787. It's not the same. Now, this jewelry up there, if you want to look at my other parts of this site called McIsencraft, I have solar jewelry of stuff that was actually unearthed over there. You can hold up to the sun, it has little holes in it, and you can hold it up on a piece of string and tell what time it is and some of your navigation aids. This isn't it, but it's similar to that. If you want to click around down there, I've also got some stuff on the Canaric sundials. See, you've seen that little devil before, haven't you, on that jewelry on that left ring? That's been going on forever. And then this doesn't have enough of a lift. Now, there's a guy with a bow and arrow. Okay, time's up. We're going to bring the shoes out and wish you all well. Here's the household god. Next one's going to be the shoes, the oldest I've ever seen. Look at these. Here's what the Romans had back there, or English, excuse me. Not much of a toe box in that shoe. A little for your heel, a little bit for your Achilles area. Man, this is something. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. Always good to have you over my shoulder when we get a chance to go do some explorations. I know some of you like this more than the other stuff we do. If you're going to get rid of a book, it's time to close this. Let's not forget that Bible. I can't tell you enough, man. It's not just that Jesus Christ is Lord and, you know, hell is hot and heaven's not. There's a wealth of information about interpreting maps, interpreting woodcuts, and the history and past and things like that. Peace to all of you. Lord bless, and goodbye for now.